President Yoweri Museveni and the Commander-in-Chief of the Uganda People's Defense Forces has advised retired generals to invest in durable assets and avoid gambling their packages. Museveni was speaking at the retirement ceremony of five generals of the UPDF at State House in Entebbe.
So that retirement package is very good for you. No, don't gamble. That's what Okidinga was telling you. These quacks, I want to put money here, it will produce money quickly, what? Go for things which are durable.
President Museveni said that he persuaded the government that the soldiers had over the years worked for no or low pay, and now that they're retiring, there was a need to ensure that they retire with a reasonable package.
I struggled very hard to make sure that as you retire, you get a good package. That's why I kept the casualty unit at Mbende. There are something like 5,000 people there. I said I cannot allow a Ugandan who is injured and crippled in the army to go to the village when we are still getting these low salaries and be a pauper there.
Honorable Jacob Oboth, the Minister of Defense and Veteran Affairs, highlighted the military's pivotal role in molding individuals from high school graduates to PhD holders and their significant contributions to the nation. He praised President Museveni's visionary and strategic leadership, which has propelled Uganda forward, particularly the UPDF beyond national borders.
We are at school, me myself with the sister Huda. We are at school. We are learning every day. And this is the military, like from the citations, is the only place that you join as you are and you come out different. People come with high school certificates and others come out with the PhDs. I worked in civil service. It is a hurdle to get a second degree or certificates. So the visionary and strategic leadership that you've given to this country and more so to the Uganda People's Defense Forces is commendable, sir. And we want to thank you very much.
Major General Silver Kayemba, speaking on behalf of the retired generals, praised President Museveni's leadership and guidance, which has elevated Uganda and the Uganda People's Defense Forces, UPDF, to global recognition. He commended the president for uniting Africans during times of instability, showcasing his exceptional leadership qualities. In response to the temporary closure of the Karuma Bridge and based on valuable feedback from key stakeholders, the Uganda Wildlife Authority has revised the previously issued transit guidelines for motorists using alternative routes through Masishon Falls National Park. Recognizing the need for increased accessibility during this period, UWA has made temporary exception to permit buses to transit via the Kichumba Nyobo Tangi route for the duration of the 3-month effective immediately until July 31st, 2024. This adjustment aims to provide greater convenience to travelers while upholding the integrity of the park. All buses transiting through the Kachumba Nyobo Tangi route must continue to adhere to the following key guidelines. Operating hours, buses will be allowed to entry between 7 a.m. and 6 p.m. Entry outside these hours remains strictly prohibited. Speed limit. The speed limit of 40 km per hour within the park is still in effect and will be enforced for the safety of both passengers and wildlife. No littering. Bus operators must ensure their passengers do not litter the park. Littering will attract a fine of 100,000 shillings per incident, and operators are expected to enforce this strictly within their vehicles. No unnecessary stops. Stopping within the park except in cases of emergency is not allowed. Following the dismissal of Dorothy Chisaka, the Kampala Capital City Authority KCCA Executive Director and two other directors, including Engineer David Luimbazi, the Deputy Executive Director, and Dr. Daniel Okello, the Director of Public Health over the Chitezi landfill incident that claimed 35 lives, the Minister for Kampala, Hajat Minsa Kavanda, yesterday revealed that the names of officials who will be acting in positions of the ousted directors shall be announced today or tomorrow.
By end of tomorrow, you shall announce those names, the three names replacing as acting directors of KCCA, the Deputy Director, the Director, and the Director Public Health.
Minsa Kavanda further retaliated that the finding in the IGG's report, which clearly outlined the severe oversight and negligence exhibited by these ousted KCC directors, was the basis for the president's decision.
There were several warnings that anything can happen anytime, so they do not react in time. According to the report, it says that warning came as from 2015. That's when the warnings came, but they did not bother. Then the president talked about it in 2018.